This is the unknown grave. The one who died maintaining his night. His will been so strong and musically inclined. His sad melodies coming out like a smoke from the woody fire. And he sang, my boo, Africa, sing now, Africa, sing loud, sing to the people. Let them give something to the world and not just take it from it. And we'll ring the bells when you come back. We'll beat the drums when you come back. When you come back, will you pity the drums? When you come back home, will you ring the bells? When you come back, will you pity the drums? When you come
back. Excellent.
Well, this is a new book called Beyond Freedom, Letters to Olusegun Obasanjo. Olusegun Obasanjo is a Nigerian. He was the president of this country in the late 70s, and his claim to fame is that he was the first one who handed, the first military, that is, who handed voluntarily power to a civilian government, and he organized free democratic elections. That was the program, how he entered office, and he saw it through. Ever since, he became a fairly well-known international statesman, which culminated in a way 5 years ago that he was one of the leading candidates for the post of Secretary General of the UN. Well, he didn't get it, of course. He lost fairly and squarely, but he moved on to become, as I said, an international mover and shaker on quite a number of issues, be it Africa, be it world food, be it peace, be it development, be it population. And as it happened in March 1995, when he came back from the social summit in Copenhagen, he was arrested by his government under the pretext of having been involved in a coup d'etat, which of course is absolutely nonsense. They could never prove it, but yet it was a convenient way of muscling him as an uncomfortable voice in his own country, who had continued to criticize the soldiers who after a while had again seized power in his native Nigeria. Now, what happened since March 1995? He never was seen again. He was put up for trial, for a secret trial, and then sent off for 15 years into prison. Of course, it was commuted from lifelong, as one would expect. But the purpose is, really, they wanted to get him from the scene and off to be no longer an uncomfortable voice in the country. Now, here's this man who was the world's darling and who has disappeared for 18 months, the man who has almost led South Africa to freedom and to multiracialism. The man who was the first one to see as an outsider and to visit Nelson Mandela when he was a co-chairman of the Eminent Persons Group of the Commonwealths, and yet he disappeared in a similar ignominious way as Nelson Mandela himself had disappeared 30 years. Will he sit for 15 years? God knows. What we can do as friends is to rally, to memorize him, and to force the powers currently in government and in other influential positions to focus on his plight. And this book is meant to focus on his plight. It contains more than 120 contributions from friends, associates, enemies, admirers, whatever you want to call them. And the beauty of it, it is embellished by about 30 different pieces of artwork by world-renowned artist. The cover is by Abdoulaye Konate from Mali, one of the foremost African painters. The back cover is from Willy Bester from South Africa, another one of the up-and-coming, exciting generation of South African artists. We have Penck, A.R. Penck from Germany is in here. We have Komal Melamed, we have Dele Jegede. We have Bill Rabinovitch, believe it or not. We have clemency, a German artist living in New York, and we have Yukinori Yanagi, who made his name with the Aunt Productions. We have Colette, Komal Melamed here. We have BHK Goodman from Germany. We have Via Lewandowski from Germany. We have Vytenis Jankūnas from Lithuania. This is Via Lewandowski with productions, computer-assisted productions he's doing. We have Twin 77 from Nigeria. We have Norman Catherine from South Africa. Elimo Nyao from Kenya. And I might add, we have Middle Art from Nigeria, Ekong Ekefrey, and then the very famous sculpturist Johannes Masmangani from South Africa also. He did a dual sculpture, one Nelson Mandela, the other one Obasanjo.
Fairly sizable pieces.
And of course we start the book with a message from Nelson Mandela. There's a prayer from Archbishop Tutu, and then there is this original letter from Nelson Mandela specifically for this book, and it's followed then by a speech of former German Chancellor Helmut Schmidt and quite a number of other people, Lee Kuan Yew from Singapore, the former Prime Minister, José Sarney from Brazil, the President, the German Foreign Minister Klaus Kinkel, the former Colombian President Pastrana Borrero is in there. And I can't repeat all of them. Of course, you have F.W. de Klerk, Nobel Prize winner. There's also the Nobel Prize winner, Wole Soyinka, the Nobel Prize winner for literature from Nigeria. And it would possibly take an hour if I would recount all the names of those wonderful, concerned people who made a point and contributed, and some contributed in an incredibly thoughtful and detailed fashion.
If any of our viewers wanted to
Well, the book is available for $35. You can send a fax to 534-0637 to me, Hans Dorwiel.
Would you spell it?
H-A-N-S, first name, and then D apostrophe O-R-V-I-L-L-E in the 212 area code, once again, 212-534-0637. $35, 700 pages of texts, and about, I would think, 40 pages of fantastically done color plates of all the arts contributions from a distinguished international array of artists. And it was printed here in the US. The layout was done by Irene Connor, and it's nice, it's worthwhile, it's engaging. And the people who have seen it by now, they were all as excited as I was and my associates were when we produced it. So maybe it interests you. And thanks to Bill, who was one of the first who came in. Thanks a lot.
This is the unknown grave, the one who died maintaining his night. His will been so strong and musically inclined. His sad melodies coming out like a smoke from the woody fire. He sang, my booye Africa, sing now Africa, sing loud, sing to the people. Let them give something to the world and not just take it from it. And will you
ring the bells when you come back? Will you beat the drums when you come back home? Will you ring the bells when you come back? Will you beat the drums when you come back?
Of our people's culture, and I'll be the one who climbs up the mountain, reaching for the top of the happy days. For the people I want to work for the reason.
Among the participants were the Secretary General of the Commonwealth, Chief Emeka Anyaoku, the permanent representative of Nigeria to the United Nations, Professor Akbola Gambari. There was the Ambassador of Romania to the United Nations. There was the President of the Ford Foundation, Mrs. Susan Beresford, the former President of the Ford Foundation, Franklin Thomas. There was former president of the Carnegie Corporation, Dr. David Hamburg. There was Wayne Fredericks, the former assistant secretary of state for Africa. There were various officials of the United Nations and other organizations. That's it.
To welcome to New York back our dear friend General Olusegun Obasanjo and Stella Obasanjo. And I don't want to say many words, just to say that it was on the 6th of March, a little over 3 years ago here, that we bid him farewell from this apartment. And
I never came back.
Anointed with due warnings, he left for the cold air of Copenhagen, and then the rest is history. So I must say, for my wife Mary, for myself, for our absent son Anush, who is a great friend of the general, that we are extremely delighted to have you back in liberty, in freedom, and on your beloved travel schedules. 3 years, 3 months, 3 days, this is what you said, and you said you had a totally new notion of what a VIP means. We all know it's a very important person, but the general, when we traveled last week through South Africa, he said it is very important prisoner. And having listened to him the last few days, I think we can also add a new dimension, very important papa, because now he emphasizes also the role of the children and that he has to look after them, and I think this is all a very round story. General, we welcome you. We are very happy that you are here, that you are resuming your rightful place. Many have doubted, many have not doubted. Some have feared, but here we all are, and I think all our hearts are shedded and open in front of you, and your duties, which you will do for the international community and for the continent of Africa and for your own country. You are welcome.
Well, have an unusual experience. You also have what I call unusual, or very new, if like new understanding of some of the things that you take for granted. I think one thing that most of us take for granted is freedom. And I used to think that what you cherish most is what you have. If you have a beautiful apartment, you love it, and you cherish it. But being deprived of freedom, I come to realize that what you in fact cherish most is what you do not have, which you need to have. Mary, I can't thank you enough. And all of you here, I can't thank you enough. And many, many who are not here, who actually make it possible for me to be alive. And I'm not joking, this is true. I myself did not know the height of danger I was in, or should I say the depth of danger I was in, whichever way you want to look at it, until I came out of prison. And an insider told me, look, what saves you in the first instance is your international friends. Because what that man planned to do was to arrest you, set up a kangaroo court within a week, and within 48 hours after that, get you out of the service of the army. And what actually prevented him from doing that was the hue and cry from my international friends. He did not expect that, and he got it. So when I go, as I go around now, people say, well, we tried, we didn't know what, we didn't get anywhere. And the first person to express that to me was Julius Yanriri, who phoned me within 24 hours of my coming out. And I said, look, you don't realize the impact of what you are doing. Well, I see that, and that is very important for all of us, particularly all of us from third world countries, that there really can be effective action against dictatorship.
You know when you carry a baby in your back and you are cooking when another carry a baby? The baby just comes out with a language. That language comes from one of my children. And then we turn it to Song of Peace because we know this children must be saying something. She's hearing something from somewhere. El well, 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 Geko, say it after me. El well, 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 El well, 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 Geko, 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 Geko. Okay, let's go. Because it's hot. Then he started doing what you call poem in another language. And I would like them to do it for you fast in 2 minutes on democracy. Before I allow them to go, they will give you the last bit.
You are our leaders. Let's go down to see ya. We need democracy, we want a change. We need democracy with a lot of it. So let's go starting with the left. So let's go starting with the left. So let's go starting with the demo. So let's go starting with the place. So let's go starting with the pambala, pambala, pambala church.
Oh, that's good to show the cover, yes.
Yeah.
It's very good.
Like that.
Yes.
Excellent. That was very nice.
Excellent.
Well, so that was a coincidence. People will do like this. There's the
good.
Very difficult.
Good.
And our videographer here, Irene, she put together this entire thing here, which is totally remarkable. Look at the size of his book. Here's the guy.
who's free now. This fellow here is here, and we've done this remarkable thing, and there...
Wait a second. He's holding the book. There we are. This is perfect.
Okay, I'm sure you did not read the entire book in one night.
Not in one night, but I read the whole entire book. The first one I read in one night, this one I couldn't read in one night.
There were some amazing articles in there.
Wonderful. Wonderful. Wonderful.
I love the piece on the cover, too. Looking out. Looking out.
Thank you. kanane fa kanane malide kele iye ne malide be barala kanane fa kanane malide kele iye ne malide be barala mali sumurun be barala male che mi semye kamalenye o male kamalemba o male kamalemba be ko male kamalemba ni bankele kananga areme kele ke chuye kamalenye ni bankele kananga areme kele ke chuye kamalenye be ko sumjata e kamalenye sumjata no kanje uye kamalenye o mali kamalembo mali denungo yesu njata no kante uye kamalenye e mali denungo yesu njata no kante uye kamalenye e mali denungo Yesu njata no kanche uye kamalenye